cheapness. Let me tell you something. Do you like monster movies? Anybody? I love monster movies. I simply adore monster movies, and the cheaper they are, the better they are. And cheapness, in the case of a monster movie, has nothing to do with the budget of the film, although it helps. But true cheapness is exemplified by visible nylon strings attached to the jaw of a giant spider. And I'll tell you a good one that I saw one time. I think the name of the film was It Conquered the World. And do you ever see that one? The monster looks sort of like an inverted ice cream cone with teeth around the bottom. It's like a teepee or a sort of a rounded off pup tent affair. And it's got fangs on the base of it. I don't know why, but it's a very threatening sight. And then he's got a frown and, you know, ugly mouth and everything. And there's this one scene where the monster is coming out of a cave, see? There's always a scene where they come out of the cave at least once. And the rest of the cast, must have been made around the 1950s. The lapels are about like that wide. The ties are about that wide and they're about this short. And they always have a little revolver that they're gonna shoot the monster with. And there's always a girl who falls down and twists her ankle. Of course there is. You know how they are. The weaker sex and everything, twisting their ankle on behalf of the little ice cream cone. Well, in this particular scene, folks, they didn't want to retake it because it must have been so good. They wanted to keep it. But when the monster came out of the cave, just over on the left-hand side of the screen, you can see about this much 2x4 attached to the bottom of the thing as the guy is pushing it out. And then, obviously, off camera, somebody's going, "No, get it back." And they drag it back just a little bit as the guy's going, now that's cheapness, right? And this is cheapness here. One, two, one, two. Watch George for the Okay, top again. Barry, I want you to take a look at their music parts here. Would you mind showing the camera? Oh. And Debbie, would you mind showing him your lovely contestant in the... wait a minute, hold it the right side up so they can see that it says over here in this area. But wait a minute, this is... the first part is, I ate a hot dog. It tasted really, real good. Then I watched a movie from Hollywood, Scream, my baby, run for your life, go to the shelter, my baby, and then several slashes, which apparently indicates that it's supposed to be repeated several times. Then it says, my baby, go to the shelter. Then over here it says, laugh, ah, ha, ha, ooh, heck, do ah. Horrible eye, several times, go rolling around, hack, doo-ah, ha-ha-ha. Now, for those of you in the audience who have already seen the musical parts that we're going to be working on tonight, when you see these parts come in, or when you hear them come into the arrangement, feel free to sing right along with us, because this sort of entertainment is wholesome and it's good for the entire family. Now let's go right to the beginning of the song and attempt to do it perfectly all the way through. Are you ready?
A movie from Hollywood. I ate a hot dog. It tasted real good.
Yum, yum.
Yum, yum, yum.
Yum, yum.
Yum, yum, yum.
Yum, yum,
yum. Then I watched a movie from Hollywood.
Yum, yum.
Yum, yum, yum.
Yum, yum.
Yum, yum, yum. Living this month with those ones behind me. I took a turn around and said, can you all see now? A little strange from the giant spider.
Pathetic.